get enlightened with the latest tools, because all these tools are very handy, very useful, and it will enable us to teach very effectively. And in fact, in the last 2 months, we ourselves, the institute, have been using various tools. In fact, even we have taught ourselves many tools so that we can teach our students very effectively. I'm certain that you have been using one or other tool, but you will come to know the plethora of tools that are available for you to use it effectively, depending on the subject, depending on the situation, we'll be able to deploy the appropriate tools. With this, I once again appreciate the Department of EAC and all the faculty members who are in the organization of this 5-day faculty development program on the efforts of online tools for teaching and learning process. I wish all the participants very informative, very useful, very engaging faculty development program. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. We will make sincere efforts to make this program a grand success. I thank our principal and HOD for addressing the participants and for taking their time to preside over the inauguration function. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
Dear teachers, the session will start in another 5 minutes. Kindly do not exit the meeting. Dear participants, each day we'll be sharing the program materials, attendance and feedback link. Assignments will be provided at the end of the program. E-certificates will be given to those who will attend all the sessions positively and submit the assignments successfully within the prescribed time limit. Now we shall start the session. I request you all to post your queries in the chat box or raise the questions at the end of the session by unmuting yourself. Now I hand over the session to resource person, Mrs. Girijamba DL. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Girijamba DL. Welcome to the session on Microsoft PowerPoint. This Microsoft PowerPoint is the most powerful app used to give the presentation purpose. And the PowerPoint is basically a graphical representation program used to organize and present the information, making your presentation more interesting and more innovative through the use of some multimedia can help to improve the audience focus also, that is students' focus. And the PowerPoint allows you to use some additional features like inserting image, inserting audio file, inserting video file, and record the slideshow, and also convert the presentation to the video file that to have a greater visual impact. Okay, we'll begin with, in this session, we are looking for how do we create a new PowerPoint file, that is how to open the file, how to close the file, and we'll discuss the every tab in the PowerPoint. We'll start now. Okay. First, to open the Microsoft PowerPoint, go to Start, Start option, and go to Start and search, and I start search for the Microsoft PowerPoint file. It is arranged in alphabetical order, so P, PowerPoint, PowerPoint. Select the PowerPoint. I request Ramesh HB sir to stop presenting, please. I request Ramesh HB sir, please stop presenting. While joining, please click on the join meeting, not present meeting.
Dear participants, there is an option called as pin to screen. So you can select that pin to screen option for Girijamba madam. You can pin to screen so that others, if they are any presenting anything, that will not be visible, and madam's presentation will be visible. So pin to screen, use pin to screen to see the presentation of Girijamba madam. And those who have joined by giving the option as present now, kindly unjoin the meeting and then join again by using the option join now, not present now. New number. Okay. Okay. We'll start now. To open the Microsoft PowerPoint.
Girijamba madam. One second.
Okay.
Just a second. Okay. Participants, kindly mute your video. It will consume more bandwidth. So just kindly mute your videos and audio. If you have any queries, you can present it. You can use the chat function to present your queries. Or at the end, you can raise your questions. So kindly mute your audios and videos. Otherwise, you'll not be able to attend the session. One more thing, when you're joining, please join. Please select the option join now and not present now. And you also use this option pin to screen to see the presentation of to see the screen of the presenter. I'll just give an overview of the program. The first day we'll be having a presentation, that is PPT presentation and Gmail account. In the second day, we'll be discussing about the Google Forms. Third day, we'll discuss about the Google Classrooms. Fourth day, it is completely about the video recordings, how to record your lectures. Fifth day also, we'll be talking about online classroom and also about different study materials and other important things like how to create passwords and puzzles and all. Okay, so once again, I request you all, many who have not muted your video, kindly mute your video and also audio.
Okay, so now we'll be starting the presentation. Now I request Girijamba madam to once again start your presentation.
Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon, participants. Welcome to the session on Microsoft PowerPoint. Microsoft PowerPoint is the most powerful app that is used to give the presentation purpose. And the PowerPoint is basically a graphical representation program that is used to organize and present the information, making your presentation more effective and more interesting through the use of multimedia can help to improve your students' focus. That's the most important thing while teaching. So PowerPoint, this PowerPoint allows you to use some additional features like that is inserting image, inserting audio file, video file, and you can record your slideshow, and also you can convert the video file. So these are all some additional features that have a greater visual impact. We'll start now. In this session, the first session is the PowerPoint presentation and Google Drive, so that is Gmail. In this session, we are looking for how do we create a new PowerPoint file, that is how to open the file, how to close the file, how to save the file, and we'll discuss every tab in PowerPoint. Okay, so let's see one by one. To open the Microsoft PowerPoint, I will go to start. And I search for the Microsoft PowerPoint file, PowerPoint. And I click on the new blank presentation. Kavya ma'am, is my screen is visible?
Yes ma'am, it is visible. You can start.
Okay, thank you madam. Thank you madam. Okay, this is the PowerPoint screen. This is the PowerPoint screen. We'll discuss everyone here. So this area on the top left, these are the buttons, that is save, undo, redo, and slideshow. This area is known as a quick access toolbar. This particular area is known as a quick access toolbar, in short, QAT. This toolbar, quick access toolbar, is available from 2007 version onwards, that is from 2007, 2010, 2013, 2015, 2016, and currently 2019 version. And these are all the tabs, that is file, home, insert, design, transitions, animations, slideshow, review, view, help. These are all the tabs. Every tab has a multiple option. This home has a multiple option. This insert has a multiple option. Design has a multiple option. Transitions has a multiple options. Like that, animations, slideshow, review, help. And this is particularly rectangular area. This is known as a ribbon. And this is the slide tab. If you want to insert additional slide, go here, click on this, you will get additional slide. Or else just click Control M, press Control M, you will get the one more tab. This is the slide tab. This is the slide. And on the bottom right, there is a minus and plus buttons are there. This is to increase this area, zoom. This is the zoom option. This is of 72%. If I click plus, you will get the maximum area. If you click minus, this area will be minimized, reduced, okay? And so this is the center at the top, this presentation one. This is the default name of the file, name of the presentation file, okay? And on the top right corner, there are three buttons are there. This is to minimize the presentation, like this, and this is to maximize the presentation, like this, and this is to close your presentation. And this is about the screen. One second. Thank you. Okay. And next, we'll discuss the first tab, that is the OHM tab. This OHM tab has few sections, that is slides, font, paragraph, and also drawing and editing. This drawing and editing also available in insert tab. Okay, we'll discuss the OHM tab now. Okay, first, this is the new slide. In slides, we have new slide, a layout, a reset, section. And if you want to include the slides, go here, click this one. You will get one more slide. Or else, just press Control M. Okay, you will get the one more slide. The first slide is the default slide, that is click to add title and click to add subtitle. Hi, participants, am I fast? If I am fast, please let me know. The first slide is the title heading title slide. Title, this is click to add title, this is click to add subtitle. And second slide, this is the title and the content slide. Title and content slide. So suppose I want to replace the third slide, fourth slide, fifth slide, all are the same slides only, that is the title and the content slide. Suppose I want to replace the third, I want another slide with some other different format. So just click on this small drop down here and select, there are different slides are available. This is the title slide, the first slide you already selected, that is the title and the subtitle. This is the title and the content, that is currently we are seeing the title and the content slide. This is the section header. This is the only title slide. This is the comparison slide, that is to compare two parameters, that is two pictures, two graphs, whatever it may be according to your requirement. And this is two content. And this is the complete blank slide, content with caption slide, picture with caption. Okay, these are all the different slides are available in here. Suppose I want to replace the slide 3 by some other slide. Let us say I want a slide, this title and content slide is replaced by content with caption. So click on this slide 3, go to layout in the slides. So select your requirement. I will select this content with caption. Okay, so what happens, the slide, the title and the content slide is replaced by this content with caption slide. You can rearrange this one according to your requirement. I can minimize this area, just click here, and you can reduce this one. Suppose I want this toward the right side, you can bring it to the right side. I have change the position of this one, this content slide. I have to change the position of this slide also. Suppose if you don't like that slide, you want to create new slide with, if you want to create the some the, okay, suppose if you want to bring it back to the original position, just click on the reset button. This reset button. Just click on this reset button, you will get the original slide only. This is about the reset section. Next section. The first slide is what? That is the title slide. Okay. So this title slide, I can name it as, go to section, add section. One dialog box will open. So rename this untitled section as untitled section as starting title. Click on enter. So the first slide is the title. So then I want to make slide number 2 and slide number 3 as a introduction slides. So click on slide number 2, go to section, select add section, and renamed this untitled section as introduction, and click on enter. So it will completely select 2, 3, 4, 5 remaining slides as introduction slides only. So next, I want to make the slide number 4 as the objective slide. So go to section, go to add section, write it as objective. Rename it as objective. Okay. Next, similarly, you can section wisely. You can arrange the slides like this. So you can minimize this section also by clicking this arrow. Okay, this is mainly to organize your PowerPoint presentation. And also in section, you can expand all the sections. You can, if you want to collapse, you can collapse all the sections. If you don't want the section, you can remove all sections. This is about the slides. Next, coming to the font. In this this home tab, to create a simple basic presentation, to start typing, just keep my cursor and start typing. Let us say I write it as Microsoft PowerPoint presentation. Presentation. So one teacher mentioned the ma'am, can you please teach again that objective one? Okay, sir. Sure, sir. That is simply, it is just section wise organized, sir. Just the first slide is the my presentation is, first slide is title one usually. So I can rename this as title slide. That first slide is the title slide. Suppose I wish to make slide number 2 and slide number 3 as a introduction slide. Suppose introduction slides. So I will go to section, add section, and I rename this untitled section as introduction slides. Introduction slides. Completely, slide number 2 and 3 are for introduction purpose. Okay. And suppose slide number 4, I will consider this as a objective slide. So go to section, add section, and I rename this section as objective, whatever it may be, according to your requirement, your subject requirement, your unit requirement, and it is, I can rename this as objective. Okay, like this, you can minimize this one. This indicates that title has only one slide, introduction has two slides. Two slides are required for introduction purpose, and for objective, two slides are required for objective purpose, like that. If you don't want the section, you can remove all the sections. That's it. Okay, so to start typing, just keep your cursor at this place, okay? And I will give the subtitle as, let us say, version, whatever it may be, version 19. And click outside, okay? So this is the title and subtitle. And in this font section, we will mainly discuss on, in fonts, we're going to discuss on, font style, font size, make a sentence, make a word or sentence bold or italic, also or underlined. Right. Next, we'll discuss with spacing between the words. Also, we're going to discuss what type of space you want. These are all the topics we'll discuss in this font section. So suppose first is the font style. So select all the sentences. There are 5 sentences are there. select all the sentences and go here, click here, font, pick a new font for your text. Okay, just click on this small drop down. There are several font styles are available, so you can choose any one according to your requirement. So suppose I choose this Franklin Heavy. Observe this, this will going to change. So whatever it may be, you can select any one of your style. Okay, and also next one is the font size. To increase the font size, click on this small drop down here. Currently it is 28. If you want to increase, 32, 36, 40, 44. If you want to decrease, you can decrease like this. Okay, or if you want to increase the font size by one or two shifts, you can use this one. That is, click this increase font size. That is, you make your text a bit bigger. That is by one or two shift. Again, if you want to increase further, just click this. In the same way, you can also decrease the font size by clicking this. Decrease the font size, make your text a bit smaller. Click one time. If you want to decrease one more time, you click this. Okay. Next, third is make a word or a sentence to bold or italic or underline. So select any word or select complete sentence, whatever it may be. Click this B, or else in short, control B. Make the text or a sentence a bold. So click this, observe the difference. This will be highlighted, bold, okay? If you don't like bold, if you don't want bold, just again click on the same B, okay? Next, if you want italic, control I. Click this and observe the difference. Okay, if you don't like italic, you can again click on that one. Okay, if you want to make the sentence underline, click here. The sentence is underlined. Okay, you can use the all three options at a time also: bold, italic, and underlined. Observe here. Okay, next we'll discuss spacing between the words. I will select one sentence. I will select this sentence only. Spacing between the words. This is the character spacing option. Adjust the spacing between the characters. Initially, by default, it is normal. Okay, this is a normal text only. If you want to tight the words, you can click on this tight. Observe the spacing between the words. If you want more tight, very tight, click on this very tight. Observe the difference. Okay, so in the same way, if you want to loose the words, you click this. You want to more very loose, click this. So usually it will, by default, it is normal. Okay, this is about the spacing between the words. Next type is what type of case you want. That may be uppercase, lowercase, like that. So select one sentence. Click on this small drop-down, change case. That is, change the selected text to uppercase, lowercase, or other common capitalizations. Click this small drop-down. By default, it is sentence case. So click lowercase, observe all the letters are in small letters only. If you click this uppercase, all the letters are in capital letters. If you click this capitalized each word, observe the starting letter of each word are in capital. Okay, next, in the same way, inverse to this capitalized each word, that is toggle case. Toggle case is nothing but the starting letter of each word are in small letters. This is about the fonts. Okay, this section is over, and if you want to if you want the font color, click on this small drop down. You can select any one of the color: red, maroon, yellow, green, whatever it may be. Okay, like that you can select the color for the text. And if you want to highlight that one, you can, text highlighting color is there. You can change the color also by click on this small drop down. Or else, if you don't want any color, just click no color. If you want to highlight the color, click on this, like this. This is to highlight the sentences. Okay, okay, next. Is the paragraph section. In this paragraph section, so observe here, there are five sentences are there. one option is there, that is bullets, create a bulleted list. If you click on this small drop down, there are many different styles of bullets are available. This is the dot, circle, so square, and tick mark. You can select anyone. Okay, this is to insert the bullets. If you want to insert, if you want to consider taking bullets as the numbers, you can use numbers also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are ABC, small letter ABC, capital letter ABC, Roman number 1, 2, 3, like that. Then, next, if you want all the five sentences must be aligned in center, click on this center alignment. This is control E, in short, center your content. Click this, all the sentences are arranged, will arrange in center. Next, align in right side, so align light or left. To justify the sentences, click this one. Next, we'll discuss with this option, that is the line spacing option. So select all the sentences. This is the line spacing option. By default, it is 1. If you want to increase the spacing option, consider it as 1.5. If you want to increase more, if you want to give more spacing, 2. So decrease like this. So this is about the line spacing option. So this is about the home tab. Next, we'll discuss with insert tab. Next, we'll discuss insert tab. So for center alignment, I'm using this one. If I want to increase, if I want this insert as a bold, click this bold. Okay, and if I want underline, click this underline. And if you want to change the color, you can change the color like that. Okay, in insert tab, first, we'll discuss about the table, how to insert a table, how to insert any picture, how to insert the shapes, how to insert the charts, that is bar chart, pie chart, line graph, and how to insert the video file, audio file, and how to insert the equation, and also how to insert any different objects into the PowerPoint file. So in insert, first we'll discuss with insert table. We'll discuss insert table, insert picture, insert picture, insert shape, insert chart, and insert object, insert audio or video file, insert audio or video. In the same way, you can insert audio also. We'll discuss one for time being. So first is insert table. To insert table, go to insert, click on this small drop down. So you select first one. This indicates a first row, one. Participants, am I fast? If I am fast, please let me know. Please put your queries in the chat box. And also, I request you to please mute your audio and video. I kindly request you to please mute your audio and video. Okay, thank you, sir. Okay. Shall I start? Thank you, Rani Madam. Okay, to insert a table, go to insert, select the table, click on this table, click on the first box. It will show in the top, that is one cross one table. That indicates one row and one column. If I select two, this indicates one row and two column. First indicates the column, then indicates the row. If I select like this, what will indicate? Two rows and two columns. Suppose I want three rows and three columns. Three rows and three columns. So once the chart is created, click on the chart. Click on the chart. There is one more tab will open, that is design and layout, that indicates to design this table. Okay, you can take any one. So by default, this is selected. You can take this, you can take according to your requirement. And also another way to insert the table is go to insert, click on the small drop down, your one option is there, insert table. Click this insert table. One dialog box will open. It will going to ask the number of rows and number of columns to be entered here. If I want two rows and two columns, click two rows and two columns and click OK. So this is the two rows and two columns. Okay, this is the three rows and three columns. So suppose I will start writing here. Let us say serial number. This is something like day. This is like color. Okay, serial number 1, 2, and day. Let us say Monday, Tuesday, and color. It may be red. It may be blue. Okay, you can change the text of this color also. Select this, and a text is there. Text fill. Click on the small drop down. You can change the color also. Okay, according to your choice. So this is the way to insert the table. Next, we'll discuss with how to insert the shapes. Again, I will select the new to insert shapes. Okay. Go to shapes. Click on the small drop down. There are different shapes are available. Line shape, rectangle shape, basic shapes, some block arrows, equation shapes, flowchart shapes are also available. Stars and banners for decoration purpose are also available. So I will select any one of them. I will click this. Just click here using mouse and leave it. Okay. And I will select one more. I will try to insert another one more shape. I will select this one like this. Okay. You can write anything on this shape. Suppose let us say hello, okay. Like this. And so like this, you can write it here. If you want to, if you don't want to color, if you want to remove this, click on this no fill. Okay. Want, you can take any one of the color. So there are here also shape styles are also available. You can select anyone like that. Start. Then shape outline color. So if I select yellow color, click this yellow color. Observe, this is a very thin line. If you want to increase the thickness, you can select anyone. You can select this, select the thickness. Wow. Then shape effects. So there's different effects are there. Press it. Shadow, reflection, glow, soft edges. So you can select anyone. Looks like some 3D. So this is the way to insert the shapes. Next. Suppose. Suppose you are writing something on this shape. And if you want to change the color of the text, go to text fill, select any one color. Select any one color. Okay. Also, text outline also can be increased by selecting the same color. The observe here, the it will be increased, and also you can change the text effects also. So this is about the insert shapes. Next, I will select one more slide. Next, we'll discuss with Insert Tag. Insert the tag. So go to Insert. In Illustration, there's a chart option is there. Click this chart. There are many charts are available. Column chart, line chart, pie chart, bar chart, area, and other additional features are also available. I will select the simple basic column chart, first one. Okay, if I select first one and I will click okay. It will take some time. Once you click, the chart is created at the back end. Along with this chart, I have got this Excel sheet also, because you cannot create the chart without the help of Excel. So this is the dummy data they have given, category, a series, some dummy values. Okay, you can change the x-axis and y-axis also. You can change category, you can change the series, you can change this one also. And suppose here, plus, click on this plus mark, chart elements. You can add some other features also. Click this, you will get chart elements as already access chart table, grid lines, legend are selected. If you want axis titles, that is x-axis, horizontal and vertical axis, x-axis, click this axis titles. You can rename this one. Axis title, this is the category one, and this is the y-axis is the series. So according to your requirement, you can give the name, and also you can change the chart title name also. If you want the data labels, you can also click this data labels. So the values, the category one, series one. This is the category one, this is category two, category three. Category one are all in blue color, category two are in orange color, category three are in gray color. So category one, this is series one. So suppose I want to change the suddenly the value of the let us say category two, category two, this series one. If I want to change this value 2.5 by 4.5, so category two, series one. So I will search, suppose I will consider this as 4.5, initially it is 2.5. Click enter, observe the value. This will also get changed automatically. So this is the stage of chart. Okay. Next, you can also change the style of the chart also, like this. There are many different shapes are available. You can choose any one. Okay. So this is about the how to insert a chart. And also you can change the color also. You can also change the color of anything. Next, in insert, we'll move to the pictures. I will add one more slide. Insert. We'll discuss with mainly how to add the pictures, how to add the pictures, and how to change the shape of a picture, how to remove the background to make it 3D look, to make the picture to a 3D look, somehow 3D look, and how to change the border, even color and shape of a picture. Finally, and how to crop the picture. So these things. First is how to add the picture. One more slide. Add the picture. Dear teachers, please, I request you to mute your audio and video. I think that's the thing. mute your audio. Dear teacher, kindly request you to mute your audio. Madam, please mute your audio and video. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay. To insert a picture, go to insert, click on this drop down. It will going to ask insert picture from the device, or you will going to are the online pictures or you will browse from online. So I have saved some pictures. I will select this device. I already saved some sample pictures. Okay, now I'll once again repeat how to insert the picture. So click here, go to insert, go to select, click on this drop down. It will ask insert picture from this device or online pictures. This device means you already saved in your system. Okay, so already say and others online pictures. So I browse from the online. So I have saved some few sample pictures. I will select this device. Okay, I already saved good sample pictures. I select one picture, insert, click insert. This is the way to insert the picture. Once I click on this picture, I will get one more tab, that is the tab.
Video is not visible.
This is basically a drawing tool. This is basically, this format tab is basically a drawing tool. That means that indicates format the picture. So click this. First one is what are you already?
Ma'am, you need a hard con.
Resume presentation. Okay. Okay. Now it is visible.
Yes, it is. You are sharing your presentation. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you, madam. So, in insert picture, add pictures. I will repeat how to add the picture again. Okay. Go to insert. Go to the pic, select, click on this picture. This will going to ask insert picture from the device or online pictures. So this device means you already saved some pictures. So I will select this. I already saved sample pictures, and I will click any one of the picture. Go to your path, okay, and click this insert button. Once you click insert, the picture is inserted here. Suppose I click outside the picture. Suppose I and observe the difference. When I click on the picture, the one more tab will open, that is format tab. This format tab is basically a drawing tool that indicates to format the picture. So first, if you already add the first topic is over, add pictures is over. Next, change the shape. In order to change the shape of this picture, go to format. Here, observe pictures are styles are available here. Click on this, click here. You will get many shapes. So observe here. If I click this, observe, it will change the shape of the picture. Suppose click this, it will also shape of the picture is changed now. Again, the shape of the picture is changed. So this is over. Next, remove the background to make it 3D look. So click on the picture, go to format. In order to remove the background, look here, look at the left hand side, there's something called as remove background option. This is automatically remove the unwanted portions of the picture. So click on this. One more tab will open under remove background, it is background removal. Here there are plus and minus symbols are there. Mark areas to keep and mark areas to remove. I will select this mark areas to keep. Just I want the animal portion only, not the background. Okay. So I click this mark areas to keep, and one pen or pencil types open. I click here. Click on the animal. So click what? Okay. Finally, these questions. Once mark areas to keep, what are the areas you want? You just click on that one. Okay, once it is done, select this one, keep changes. Okay, observe here and go to slideshow. There's a slideshow tab is there, slideshow. From beginning, from current slides are there. So from current slide means present slide will visible. Go to slideshow, from current slide. It looks like some 3D look, also like that, you can do. Escape. So this is the third one is also over, that is the remove background to make it 3D look. Next, change the border, color and shape of a picture. I will insert one more tab, one more slide. Change color. Again, insert on any picture. Insert picture from this device. I will select this one. Click insert. It is inserted now. To change the color of this picture, click this picture. Again, the format tab will open. Okay, here on left side, one option is there, color. Change the color of the picture to improve the quality or match the document content. So click this color, okay? You click anyone. Just click here, anything. So observe the difference. The color, shape of the color of this picture is changed now. Okay? This is, in this way you can change the color. And also you can give the, change the picture border also, picture border. So suppose I select yellow color. So the picture border is now yellow color. It is not visible. So the, because the thickness is very less. So if I want to increase the thickness, observe the yellow color will appear. Next, finally, how to crop the picture. Suppose I want just the face of this animal, just only the, suppose I will consider the eye portion of this animal to crop. So select, click on this picture, go to format, the tab will open. Here on the right side, a crop option is there. Crop your picture to remove any unwanted areas. So crop this one. This square box will open. I just want the eye portion of this animal. Okay, use the mouse and then click outside. This is the way to crop the animal. So this completes the picture portion. Insert picture is done. Next, I will select one more slide. Insert our object. Insert objects. In this, you can insert any different objects in PowerPoint file. You can insert Word file or Excel file or PDF file, Notepad file. Okay. Some. You can insert the Word file, Excel file, PDF file, Notepad, PowerPoint, and any other different objects. So first, we'll discuss with how to insert a Word file. You can insert PDF file or Excel file or Notepad. You can insert Notepad also. For timing, we'll discuss only these three things. So we'll first insert the Word file. To insert Word. So insert Word. Okay. Go to insert. In the text section, first is the text box. Second is the header and footer. Word art. Next, date and time. After date and time, insert slide number. This is the object. Insert object. So click on this object. So one dialog box will open. It says like this. That is, do you want to create a new document or do you want to browse the existing one? So I have created some few files already. So I just go to this option, create file from. I will browse the file. I have created some sample documents. I click this word, click OK. Okay, again, it will ask, do you want to link it to the Word document or do you want to attach the entire Word document in the PowerPoint file? And also it will going to ask display as icon. Do you want to display Microsoft Word as an icon or do you want to attach the Word document as an entire file? So I just want to attach the entire Word document to the PowerPoint. So I just click OK. Okay, 1 second. So can you explain again, insert word? Sure, sir. To insert a Word document file, insert, this is Microsoft Word document file. Word document file. To insert document, I'll go to insert. In the text column, there is a text box. Here and footer, word out, after word out, date and time, sliding number, then object is there. So select this object. To insert any object, go to insert, click on the object. Once you click on this object, it gives me a dialog box. It says, do you want to create a new file or do you want to browse the existing one? I already created some files. So I just go to this option and I browse that file. I browse the Word file. Click on the Word document. This is the Word document. I click OK. Okay. Then it will again ask the two options. One is the link option, another one is the display option. That is, link is nothing but do you want to link it to the Word document or do you want to attach the entire Word document in PowerPoint file? So I want the entire document to attach it in the PowerPoint. And again, it will ask, do you want to display the Word as an icon? Or do you want to display do you want entire Word document in PowerPoint? I want to attach the entire Word document in PowerPoint. So I click OK. It will take some time. Okay, this is the Word document. Okay, once you double click on this Word document, what is going to happen? Observe, the ribbon of this PowerPoint presentation is changed to the Word ribbon. That is, layout, references, mailings are not in the PowerPoint. Okay, so you can edit this one. Suppose select the sentences. You can highlight the sentence. You can also change the font color. You can also increase font style, font. You can also change the font style, font size. Okay, like that. Suppose I want to increase this font size by 14. Observe the difference. Once you made the changes, click outside. Again, the ribbon of the Word is changed to the ribbon of the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, this is the way to insert the Word document. Next, we'll try to insert the Excel file. Insert Excel document. Excel file or Excel document. To insert a Excel, go to insert. Again, go to the same thing, in the same way, same procedure, like a Word file. Go to select, click on object. Again, create file from. Go to browse. I've created some documents. Sample documents, that is Excel. Click Excel, click OK, okay. This time, I don't want the entire Excel document to attach it to the PowerPoint file. Just I want to display it as an icon. So click on display as icon. Okay. If you want to change the icon, click on this change icon. There are different versions of icons are available. That is older version of Excel, newer version of Excel, or some other shapes. Okay. I will select this one. and give the caption as click to open Excel file and OK. Then click OK. Only the icon will appear here, not the document of entire document of Excel. So if you click on this Excel, the document of Excel is opened. Next, auto insert a notepad. To insert the notepad, the same procedure. Go to object, browse file from notepad, select notepad, click OK, click again OK. This is the way to insert any different objects into your Microsoft PowerPoint. This file is open now, like that you can open. So insert picture is also over. Next we'll discuss with how to insert a video file or audio file. Again, I will select the new slide. Insert a video. The same way you can insert the audio file also. So go to audio, video. On if you there is it will going to ask browse the video from online or video on my PC. Insert. Play this one.
Numerical aperture. The range of acceptance angles rotated around an axis where light can be coupled into a waveguide, such as the core of an optical fiber.
So in this way, you can insert the video file. In the same way, you can also insert your audio file also. So we'll move to the another tab, that is the design tab. Next is the design tab, after design tab. This tab is used to apply a design to a PowerPoint presentation. There are different designs are available. So click here. There are many themes are available. So okay, again show me how to insert video. Okay, sure sir. Okay, to insert a video, go to insert. It will going to ask online video or video on my PC. That is to browse the video. You can type the, you need to type the URL of this video. So our video on my PC, I saved some video file. So click, select the video, click insert. And if you want to play, your play option is there. Play and play or pass, click this.
Numerical aperture. The range of acceptance angles rotated around an axis where light can be coupled into a waveguide, such as the core of an optical fiber.
Okay, in this way you can play the video. Okay, next we'll move to the design tab. So this tab is used to apply a design to a PowerPoint presentation. There are different types of designs are available. Just click on this small drop down, you will get many options. So you can change your slides like this. And it will be applicable to all the slides. So you can change the design to your slides. So this is about the design tab. Next, we'll move to the transition. This is an important one. And I'll insert slides, home, new slide, in transitions. We'll discuss with the main topics are transition to slides, and we'll discuss with effect option. Also, we'll discuss with the sounding effect, that last duration for the transition. So transition is something which is giving effect to the slides. Something which is giving effect to the slides. That means, suppose I select this slide, okay, and move to transitions. There are many transitions are available. Click on the small drop down. These are all the transitions. This is exciting transitions. It's like some looking, it's like some 3D look. Okay. So I select the transition as a wipe transition. Observe. This is the wipe transition. And also give the effect options. That means this is the wipe transition. This is the effect I'm giving to the slide. And go select this effect options. This wipe transition will take, select anyone from left. If I take left, observe the difference. If I take from top right, observe the difference like that, okay? So this without slideshow option also, you can see the difference in this preview.
Excuse me, ma'am. Again, your presentation had gone.
Oh. Okay. This one presenting.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Okay. The transitions. We'll repeat again. The transition few topics. The topics to be covered in transitions are transition to slides, effect option, sound, duration. So transition is something which is giving effect to the slides. Select the slide, okay? And these are all the transitions. Many transitions are, different types of transitions are also available. So that is morph, fade, push, wipe, split, reveal. And in exciting also, there are many transitions are available. These are dynamic content transitions are also available. I will select wipe. After selecting this, observe the difference. Without slideshow also, you can see the difference in this preview. Like this, okay? Once you select the wipe transition, so this is the effect I'm giving to the slide. So go to effect option. Suppose I select this from top, observe. It will from top, this wipe transition is from top. See the difference in preview, like this, okay? And also, next one, if you see, for how much duration do you want? That is the transition for how much duration you want. In this here, looking at the right hand side, there's something called as timing. Timing is there. In this timing, duration is the duration. This wipe transition is applicable to 1 second only. Duration, just this, click on this above arrow mark to increase this 1.25 seconds, 1.5 seconds, 1.75 seconds, 2 seconds. So I will select 2 seconds and go to preview. 1, 2. So it takes the duration. Okay, if you want to decrease the duration, again, you can decrease the duration. Okay, next is, we'll discuss with sound effect. Sound effect. Here, one option is there, sound option is there. Click on this, initially no sound. So if I, these are all the sounds are available. So if I select applause, and go to preview like this. So you can also give, suppose if I select the first slide, no sound is there. If I select the first slide, applause slide, and it, this will for the wipe, and also I will going to apply the split transition, and I will, the duration for this is 1 second. Okay, next, you can make the changes.
Excuse me, ma'am, again, we lost the presentation. Somebody is entering to presenting. I think we are losing it.
Okay, ma'am.
Hello, participants. What you can do is you can pin the screen of the presenter. You have the option where you can pin the screen of the presenter. Okay, so if others are trying to present something, that will not be visible and you'll be able to see the presentation of the presenter only. Presenter is Mrs. Girijamba DL EC. So you can select that, and if you click over there, you'll have three options where you have pin option, where unmute and remove option. So you can pin select the pin option. So you can pin the screen of the presenter. So you'll not be able to see the screen of the other presenters. Thank you. You can see here you have this option, pin to screen. You cannot unmute, okay, and one more option. So in that, if you pin to, use the option pin to screen, the screen of the presenter will be visible to you. Others other screen will not be visible. So you use this option pin to screen to pin your pin the screen of the presenter. Thank you. In mobile, you can see you have people list, you have chart and information. So in people list, you can see who are else in the other in the meeting. Okay, so you can go there and you can select Mrs. Girijamba DL and click on that. So there, if you click on that, you'll get the option, all the three options. So in mobile, you have to go to people. So where you have all the people present in the meeting. So go to Girijamba DL, and if you click on this the photo of Ms. Girijamba DL, it will be pinned. Or if you click on the name, you'll get the three options. So just click on the photo of the Girijamba DL ma'am's photo, so it will be pinned. Thank you.
Transitions. Transition is something which is giving effect to the slides. That is, to select any one of the slide, I select this one. If I click on this wipe transition, okay, you can also change the effect option from top, from left, from right, from bottom. You can give any one of them. I will select from left. Without slideshow option, also you can preview the difference. Like this, okay. And also, next one, if you see, for how much duration do you want the transition? For how much duration do you want? Yeah, duration option is there. You can this transition, wipe transmission to this slide is applicable only in 1 second. If you want to increase the transition duration, you can increase by 1 or 2 seconds, like that. Okay, if you want to decrease, you can decrease also. Next, sounding effect. Sounds is there to give the sounding effect to the slide. Suppose I will select the first slide. First, I set the first slide. I will select the split option, split transition, and this split transition is from horizontal, so like this. And sound system for this is applause. Okay, and also I can change the transitions sound duration for second slide also. If you want the same transition, same sound effect, same duration, then select click on this. Select apply to all. Click this apply to all. It will be same for the remaining slides also. So if you want to change, you can change. Okay. Once I click this apply to all. Okay. Go to slideshow from beginning. Next slide. One second. Transitions. Select all the slides. Okay. Select the transition as split, and the effect is from horizontal. Okay. And the sounds is applause, and it is applied to all the slides. So go to slideshow from beginning. Wait just a minute. Transitions. Okay. Go to slideshow. If you want to change the animation, if you want to change the transitions, you can change the transitions also. Suppose if you want some 3D look, let us say I will select this onikun. So in the same way. So go to slide number one. Go to slideshow from beginning. Next, I click on the mouse. Next slide. I click on the mouse for third slide. I change the sounding effect. So you can change the sounding effect also. Next is after here, when I click on the mouse only, then only the slides are moving. But if you want, the slides will move automatically without clicking the mouse. That is, there's one more option in the timing. In advanced slides, untick this on mouse click. I want the slides will move every after some seconds. That is, let us say 2 seconds without click the mouse. Select all the slides, Control A. Then click on after 2 seconds. Just then I'll go to the slideshow again from beginning. This is the first slide, and the next slide is automatically changed. Third slide, after 2 seconds, this will also automatically change. The same way you can do it. We'll discuss with animation. Go to home, insert new slide, animations. We'll see some few tricks. That is, first trick, focus, play in reverse order, and third, stop all the animations in one go trick. These we'll discuss three tricks. The first is the shift the focus. Go to insert insert one more slide. So I will write some few sentences, few points. That is, first I will write, let us say, first sentence. Second sentence. Third point. And fourth point. Fourth sentence. There are four sentences are there. First trick is the shift the focus, right? So shift the focus trick. So select all the sentences, go to animations, in animations, okay? Select the animation, let us select a wipe. I will select the wipe, okay? And give the effect option from left. I will select from left, okay? And arm click only. See, a start option, in timing start option is there. When you click on the mouse, okay, it will show the animation. Let's see the animation now. Go to slideshow from current slide. Shift the focus. Okay, I will click the mouse. First point will appear. I will again click the mouse. Second point will appear. Again click the mouse. Third point. Fourth point. This is the normal animation. To be a bit different, go to animations. Select all the points. Okay. Select the transition and give the effect option as left or whatever it may be, and click on click. Not when you click on the mouse, then go to this, select this animation. Animation pane, and click on this small drop down. There is an effect option as well. Click this effect option. In effect, the animation section, after animation, go boom. Click here and click the color of your choice. I will select this one. Click OK. Then go to slideshow from current slideshow. And I click the mouse. The first point, first sentence will appear. Next, I will click on the mouse. Observe here. The first point will be well now. Second point will be highlighted. The same way, third point, third sentence is highlighted by dimming the second sentence. And again, fourth sentence is highlighted by hiding the third sentence to dim the previous sentences. So this is one trick. Animation show again. Okay, sure, madam. Thank you. I will repeat the animations again. In animation, we discuss with mainly three tricks: how to shift the focus trick and play in the reverse order trick, and stop all the animations in one go trick. We'll discuss with the first one: how to shift the focus. So these are all the sentences. Some sentences. I've written four sentences. So click the sentences. Okay. Go to animations. Okay. Select the animation. There are different animations are available in the same way like the transition. I will click on this wipe animation, and also I will select the effect options from left. Okay. Then once I click on the mouse, it will start. Okay. Then go to slideshow, observe the animation, go from current slide, this current slide only, this slide. Then I click on the mouse. The first point will appear. Again, I will going to click the mouse. Second sentence will appear. And then I click the third sentence will appear. Again, click on the next mouse, fourth point will appear. So this is about the first one, shift the focus. Next, we'll discuss with the second trick, the play in reverse order. So I will insert one more tab, one more slide, how to play in reverse order. I will copy the same four sentences, Control C for copy. to paste, control V. Okay, play in reverse order. So here, instead of selecting all the sentences, select complete this section, complete section, go to animations, go to animation, select the animation of your choice. Okay, and select the effect options from this time from right. Okay, and this once click on the mouse, it will going to start. Okay, next, go to animation pane, click on this small drop down, go to effect options. This time one more tab will open, that is text animation tab. Click this text animation tab and select in reverse order, click OK. Okay, observe the difference. Go to slideshow, from current slide. Once I click on the mouse, click the mouse. This one, slideshow from current slide. Once I click the mouse, the fourth sentence will appear now. Next, again, I will click the mouse. Third sentence will appear. Again, click the mouse. Second sentence will appear. Again, click the mouse. First sentence will appear. This is useful when you reveal the first, second, third place or consolation places in the classroom. So this next is stop all the animations in one go trick. How to stop the animations in all the slides? So it's a simple one. Go to stop all the animations, go to slideshow. There is one option is there. Set up slideshow. Here, go to show option. Click this show without animation. Click OK. Okay. Then go again. Go to slideshow from current slide. There is no animation. There. All the points will appear at a time. So escape. Okay. So this is the way to stop the animations. If you want animation again, go to slideshow. Go to setup slideshow. In show option, show. Untick this show without animation and click OK. Okay, next. This completes the animation sections. Okay, next, a slideshow. Slideshow is simple. If you want to play the slides from beginning, you can select the beginning. From beginning means the first slide. Okay. If you want to slideshow, suppose I mean slide number 5, if you want to show this slide, so click this from current slide. Okay. As like that. Next, here one option is there, record slideshow. How to record the slideshow? So click this, click on this small drop down. It will going to ask record from current slide or record from beginning. I will select this record from beginning. Once I click this, this screen will open. Okay. Here, one option is that this turn microphone off, turn camera off. You can turn off your camera also. One second. Okay, in slideshow, to record the slideshow, go to record slideshow, the record from beginning, select the record from beginning. Okay, this window will open. Okay, this is the slide number 1. I will going to record from the beginning slide. Okay, to record, here few options are there. This is the turn microphone off. This should be on only. Turn camera on. If you want to, this is the way to turn on the camera. If you don't like, you can turn off the camera also. Okay, if you want, you can turn on the camera. Next, while explaining, you can use this laser pointer option also. This is the laser pointer option. Click this. See, this is going to highlight like this. Okay, and also here one pen option is there, to underline or to cross mark like this. You can use. Okay, and here highlighter is there to highlight this one. To highlight the sentences, you can use this one. This is the first slide. So to record the slide, I will select the laser pointer, start recording, click on this start recording, start the recording, red button, 3, 2, 1, start explaining the slides. This is the first slide, start explaining the slides. Then for the second slide, next slide, click this and you can explain the slides also. In the same way, you can explain all the slides. This is the third slide, that is in the slide third, that is the insert table, how to insert the picture, how to insert shape, how to insert chart, insert object, insert video. So this is the table, shapes, this is the chart, this is the picture, insert picture, procedure, to crop out the picture. This is the change the shape of the picture and also color. The next, insert objects. Insert the insert any different documents into the PowerPoint. Excel, Word, and Notepad. Okay. So insert video. Next slide. Slides. Shift the focus, click. Play in reverse order technique. So there are 4 points. And this is the last slide. Once you completed, then close, stop recording. Click on this. Not yet started the recording actually. Okay. I will start explaining again. To record the slideshow, go to slideshow, click this small drop down, record slideshow here. So it will going to ask record from current slide or record from beginning. I will select record from beginning. Record from beginning. Before that, 1 second, please. I need to clear the previous record. Clear all narrations. Clear narrations on all the slides. Okay. Slideshow. Record slideshow. Record from the beginning. Then this screen will open to record. While recording, so if you don't want to turn on the camera, you can turn off the camera. If you want, you can keep it again. Keep it like this. Then while explaining, you can use this laser pointer also. Let the words, or else if you want to underline or anything, you can use this pen like this. If you want to highlight the sentences, you can use this one. So I will take the laser pointer. Okay. So once click on this start recording, red button. This is the first slide, Microsoft PowerPoint version 19, explaining the slides, start explaining the slides. Go to next slide. This is the second slide. The second slide will discuss about the fonts, that is the font style, font size, make a word or a sentence to bold, italic, or underlined. And also we'll discuss about the spacing between the words, and also we'll discuss about the what type of cases you want, that is uppercase, lowercase, sentence case, like that. In next slide, discuss about the insert tab, to how to insert the table, how to insert the picture, how to insert the shape, how to insert a chart, also into insert the different object, that is the Word file, Excel file, PDF file, any document into the PowerPoint presentation, and how to insert the video file or audio file. Discuss in the insert tab. So this is the table, shapes, chart, pictures, you crop the picture, change the color of the picture, and insert the objects, inserted objects. This is the Word document attached to the file. Excel icon is attached here. Notepad inserted. Next video is inserted. Next, we'll discuss in transitions. Main topics are transition to the slide, that is giving effect to the slides, effect option, sounding effect, and duration. The transition for the duration, how much you want. So next, animations. There are three tricks we'll learn. That is shift the focus, play in reverse order, stop all the animations in one go trick. Next, this is the first technique. Shift the focus and next. Play in reverse order. This is the play in reverse order technique. Next, stop all next. So once you completed, okay, click on this stop, okay, and close this one. Then go to slideshow from the beginning, play from the beginning, observe. The first slide, Microsoft PowerPoint version 19. Explaining the slides, that is explaining the slides. Go to next slide. Second slide. Second slide will discuss about the fonts, that is the font style, font size, make a word or a sentence to bold, italic, or underline. And also we'll discuss about the spacing between the words, and also we'll discuss about the what type of cases you want, that is uppercase, lowercase, sentence case, like that. In next slide, discuss about the insert tab, to how to insert a table, how to insert a picture, how to insert a shape, how to insert a chart, also to insert a different object, that is the Word file, Excel file, PDF file, any document into the. This is the table. Okay. Once completed the recording the slideshow, so go to slideshow from the beginning, observe the video. The first slide, Microsoft PowerPoint version 19. Explaining the slides, that is explaining the slides. Go to next slide. The second slide. Second slide will discuss about the fonts, that is the font style, font size, make a word or a sentence to bold, italic, or underline. And also we'll discuss about the spacing between the words, and also we'll discuss about the what type of cases you want, that is uppercase, lowercase, sentence case, like that. In next slide, discuss about the insert tab, to how to insert the table, how to insert the picture, how to insert the shape, how to insert a chart, also to insert a different object, that is the Word file, Excel file, PDF file, any document into the PowerPoint presentation, and how to insert the video file or audio file. Discuss in the insert tab. So this is the table. Shapes. Okay. In this way you can play your video. Okay. At last, save to save the file, go to the file tab. Here, save as option is there. It's going to ask the location to save the file. I'll select the desktop. Any location you can choose. I'll choose the desktop here. So give the presentation name as any. You can give any name according to the your choice. PowerPoint. Presentation for teachers training program. Okay. Then select save, click save. Next, we'll discuss with how to convert this presentation to the video. So So go to the file. How have you overlaid your video on your presentation? So this, I'm using the version here, it is 2019 version. Actually, from 2016 version, it is available, this one. Okay, at last, okay, to convert this, okay, this, go to slideshow, record slideshow. Let us say I will from the beginning, record from the beginning. Here, you can hide this camera also, otherwise you can turn on the camera, you can see your video like that. If you select camera only, then only this is displayed. Next, we'll move to the next last topic, that is how to convert this presentation into a video. Go to file, go to select save as. So once you save the file, go to select export. Then go to full HD 1080 pixels, or you can select your requirement. I will select full HD, create video. In desktop, it will going to ask save as this video in desktop only. I will choose the desktop option. You can choose any location, you can change the location also. Click save. It will take time to load. Could you please, which topic you want me to repeat, sir? Any other sari bad, sir?
Repeat just before what you have done. Converting the structure.
Converting? Ma'am, please. Ma'am? Which topic you want me to repeat?
Yes, ma'am. How to convert the slideshow into a video.
Okay, okay. How to convert the PPT to the video, right? Okay, sure. I will explain. Ma'am, go to file, here file tab, go to file tab. In file tab, there is one option is there, export. Click on this export, okay? Once you click this export, there is a export your video option is there. Click on this export your video, create a video. In create a video, you can select the video size. Video size, large file size is there, medium file size is there, smallest file size is there, largest file size is there. So you can select your requirement. And once you select, then click on this create video, the video will be created. But it takes much time. Okay. But I created one sample video. I will show that video here. I will show created video from PowerPoint presentation. This is the video I have created from presentation, PowerPoint presentation. This is a sample video. PowerPoint presentation to the video. This is the slide number one, slide one. Next slide two, the lion, the animal, lion. Tiger. Tiger, this is the national animal of India. It has a great yellow coat of fur with dark stripes. Later on, it was replaced by the tiger. The combination of stamina, strength, and agility, and also tremendous power as made the tiger as the national animal of India. So this is the sample video from PowerPoint presentation conversion. Any questions?
Ma'am, for converting into video, we need any app?
One second, madam. Yes, madam.
Ma'am, to convert as a PPT as a video, we need any app?
Sorry? Requirement. The app requirement is slide recording. Ma'am, please type your questions. Madam, please type your questions in the chat box. Please type your questions in the chat box.
Hello, participants. There is one more session after this that is only for 10 minutes. So kindly do not leave the meeting. For this PPT presentation has just ended. You can ask any doubts regarding that. And after that, just 2 minutes after that, we'll start with that one more presentation. It will be for 10 minutes, that's all. So kindly do not leave the meeting.
Okay, Shashikala ma'am, you can add any your own audio also. To convert PPT into video, any app is required? No ma'am, no, nothing will be required. Just go to export and click on select the create video and select the size of the video. It may be large, medium, or extra large file size. Would you also post these explanations or the materials in the group? Definitely, sir. Definitely, in the group.
Okay, now the PPT session has ended. Now we'll just have a very small video of our college, of our institution, Vidyavardhaka College. That is only for less than a minute. That is only for the break purpose, that's all. And then after that, we'll start one more session that is only for 10 minutes. So kindly be with us. Then somebody else is presenting.
A very good afternoon, everyone. I, Megha V, Assistant Professor, Department of Information Science and Engineering, VVCE, Mysuru.
Okay, after this a small break, we'll have a very small session on Google Drive. We'll start in 1 minute.
Hello, participant. Next, we'll move to the next session, that is the Google Drive. How to send your larger files using Google Drive. So, I hope you all created a Gmail account. So, you know, I hope you know the Gmail account creation. So, next, directly move to the Google Drive. Google Drive. Okay. This is the Gmail account of mine. To send your larger files, because Gmail supports only 25 MB of files only. If the file size is larger than 25 MB, you can transfer the files to the particular recipient using Google Drive. Go to Compose Mail to auto compose the mail. Click on this Compose Mail, compose. Then there is one option is there in triangular option. This is how to insert the files using Drive. Click this. Okay, one dialog box will open. Then there is an upload here to upload the file. Select files from your device. Okay, select files from your device. The file size is larger than 25 MB. You can transfer the file using through the Drive. click open, select open, and click on this upload button to upload the file. It will take some time to upload the file. This file size is lesser than 25 MB only. If the file size is larger than 25 MB, you can use this drive. So it takes some time. It's almost completed now. Okay, it's complete. The file is attached here, and recipient to whom you want to transfer the files. I will set the recipients. Savitri B. Raj. Then I will let the subject. Network. Curry. Okay. Then click the send button. Click send. While sending, one more dialog box will open. They share with the one person. So he can view the file or comment the file, can edit the file. If you select edit, she can edit the file. If you select view only, she can view the file only. Okay. So then click on send. It will send to the particular recipient. This is the way to transfer the file. The file size is larger than 25 MB because Gmail supports only 25 MB of file. And also, click on this Google Apps, every Gmail account. Different apps are available in Gmail account. See here, Google Drive, Calendar, Google Documents, that is Google Forms, Google Classrooms. So in one Gmail account, there are different apps are available. In Google Drive, select this Google Drive. Whatever you create in Google Forms, Google Classroom are automatically saved in this Google Drive. So this is one app, important app in this document. Is there any doubt? Please ask in the chat box. Please type your questions in the chat box. If you have any doubt regarding this. Thank you all the participants for your patience listening. Thank you all.
Thank you all the participants. I hope the session was useful to you all. Just now, Girijamba Madam showed you the different Google apps. So from tomorrow and day after tomorrow, we'll be studying some of those Google apps. Okay, tomorrow the session will start at the same time, that is at 2:30. And we'll be sending the attendance link and also the feedback link, and also we'll be sharing the materials by today night. And to fill the attendance link, today it will be open till 10 p.m. So kindly fill the attendance and feedback before 10 p.m. today. Thank you all.
Hello. Ma'am, Girija ma'am, are you in line? Girija ma'am. Girija ma'am.
Ma'am, how to log out? Ma'am, how to log out?
How to left, ma'am?
ಸೊ ಲೀವ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು ನಾನು ಅದೇ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಯ್ತು ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ.